New York City is under siege by the Hand, and the only thing keeping it together is Matt Murdock. Can Daredevil overcome? Well, let's catch up on Daredevil's issue number 603, 604, and 605 to find out. Alrighty then, so this has been long overdue, so let's not waste any time, let's get to it. For those of you who remember, back in the previous issue, the Hand seemingly absconded with the entirety of the NYPD. Like, literally stole the entire police station out of the Earth itself. This means Daredevil is gonna have to get a little bit more creative when it comes to drumming up extra forces to help protect the city from evil ninjas. First up on his list is Elektra, after all, who besides him has more experience fighting the Hand and just, well, experience with the Hand in general. Then again, with Elektra, you can never really be sure whose side she's on. Then, of course, there's the whole problem of motivating her. She is a self-centered assassin, after all, and was already in the process of getting out of town while the getting was good. The only reason she agrees to help Daredevil out is on the condition that if she does, our hero will tell her who messed with her mind all those arcs back and made her think she had a missing daughter that she didn't. That's not the only controversial draft pick Daredevil is forced to make this issue either. We still have all the locked up crime bosses from the previous issues. With the cops either dead or missing and the superhero community stretched thin, Matt Murdock uses his powers as intern mayor to get all the gang lords out of prison on the condition that they're willing to help fight back the ninjas. Matt admits this will probably hurt his overall approval rating, but hey, he ain't fighting for re-election next year or anything. This is all gonna be Fisk's problem once everything is solved. Now, a land war with the Hand is going to be difficult, but it's not truly unwinnable. That is, of course, when the Beast, the god of the Hand, decides to play his ace. A terrifying bioweapon expelled from his own body that causes people to get sick, keel over, and in some cases even turn to the Hand. It's a burp, basically. He has a terrible, gnarly burp. This also apparently messes with time and space as well, which also might explain why no other international heroes step on in to lend a hand when this is clearly such a big problem. Matt, having super senses, ends up getting affected by the gas first before anyone else and taken ill. Everything looks like it's lost, that is, until a very unlikely ally steps out from the shadows. And I know I say that sort of thing a lot, but no, I really mean this person was unexpected. It's Father Jordan, everyone. Yeah, you remember him. He's Matt Murdock's priest, the one that he spilled his guts to about using the Purple Children's power to make everyone forget about him. You'll remember this guy said he was a warrior priest, part of a special order of holy Catholic warriors. Well, turns out he wasn't bullshitting, he was 100% honest. His group, the Ordo Draconum, that's the Order of the Dragon for those of you who don't speak Latin, have come to New York to help fight the good fight, and oh my god, these guys are basically the Iscariot organization from Helsing. They're so freaking cool, Jordan even does a little exorcism ritual on Matt to get him back into the fight and to expel all the evil he absorbed. We also learn about the group's origin. They were a set of Templars who served the Hungarian king back in the 15th century, but then they got into the monster slaying business, as you do. And now, at this moment of need, they've come to help out Daredevil in New York City. This means Daredevil quite literally leads his own crusade deep into Hand territory. He even gets his own sword to start fighting ninjas with. Oh my god, this is so cool. Of course, the Beast is smart, only pretending to be in one location while he leads our heroes into an archer firing squad. Elsewhere, just to make matters worse, Fisk comes too and wants to take control of the situation again as acting mayor. As we discover, the Beast's real goal is to take City Hall. That's where Blindspot is right now. Sam was the one who did him wrong, not giving his soul in exchange for the power it took to kill Muse. Now, Daredevil and the few Draconum members who still survived are trapped downtown by archers. They know they need to make their way to City Hall quickly, but to do so on foot would be suicide against the sea of Hand ninjas. Luckily, this is New York, and cops occasionally ride horses, which mean, oh my god, this is so cool. Matt Murdock and his warrior monk friends ride a bunch of police horses over to save the day. Hey, is anyone else getting a real serious Dark Knight Returns vibe right here, right now? Because I know I am, and I'm liking it. Blindspot actually talks about maybe giving himself up to the Beast, after all he's the one that incurred his wrath, but once the chief of police discovers that Blindspot actually killed the cop killer Muse, opts to take up his defense. That seems like an odd reason to want to protect someone, but okay, you do you. What follows is the Battle of City Hall, where in masked superheroes, warrior monks, and undead ninjas all fight in downtown New York. I do believe the dictionary definition of this is crazy as hell, and I would not have it any other way. Seriously, moments like this are why I read comics. Daredevil manages to summon up enough strength to defeat the Beast, or at least defeat as much as you can an abstract god like this. He'll be back, but not for a while. Sam is still horribly racked with guilt over what his choices wrought on the city. He needs to get away for a while. Luckily, we know an order of super awesome warrior monks who are looking for new members now anyway. Plus, with that much guilt and self-hate in him, he's gonna make a great Catholic, I just know it. And with that, the day is more or less saved. Wilson Fisk regains control of the mayor's office, Matt choosing to step down as deputy mayor, but not before convincing the Kingpin to drop his anti-superhero agenda. In the light of, well, you know, the superhero saving everyone in New York, including Fisk himself. On his way out the door, though, Matt does manage to overhear Fisk talking to Wesley about how they did indeed fix the election. And with that, it looks like Matt has his new mission right there as the comic ends. So that was Daredevil issues number 603 to 605, everybody, and if you couldn't tell, I absolutely loved the ride I was taken on here. This, I think, ended up being some of Charles Soule's absolute best work on the character, which is saying something because that work is really starting to pile up. This was so good, it very easily could have been the last word written on the series, and I would have been happy. It ties up a ton of dangling plot threads, allows Sam to actually grow and change as a character, and also exit the book, but in a respectable way. In fact, I think the only thing holding this back from a full 10 on 10 is the artwork, which sadly has always kind of been a detriment to this series. It definitely looked as good as it ever has here in this issue. And with the next arc to have Phil Noto in it, I think we're going to be in good hands. Overall, I give this one a very strong 9 out of 10.
Hey there, everyone. It's Cape Jewel again, and I want to thank you for watching to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and as always, why not check out some of these other videos I'm hard at work on? Then, as always, you can follow me on Twitter and Facebook at Cape Jewel, so you're up to date on what I got coming out next. And if you're feeling in a supportive mood, please, by all means, check out my Patreon, link down in the description. Patrons get exclusive access to videos and content before anyone else, and you can do so for as little as $1 a month. So until next time, everyone, this has been Cape Jewel. I will be back again with more great comic content that smacks of greatness. Bye-bye, everybody.